Ankylosing spondylitis is an autoimmune inflammatory disease that mainly affects the spine on your back. It's a type of inflammatory condition, among others, known as spondyloarthritis. As a part of the body's mechanism of inflammation, the ligament that attaches to the vertebrae receives calcium. This causes the bone cells to grow from the sides of the vertebrae. Eventually, the individual bones of your spine may fuse and lose flexibility. This is called ankylosis. It often starts in your late teens or 20s. Related conditions. Some conditions that can be confused with ankylosing spondylitis are non-radiographic ankylosing spondylitis, undifferentiated spondyloarthritis or USPA when the disease is still in the early stage, psoriatic spondyloarthritis, enteropathic arthritis, reactive arthritis, juvenile idiopathic arthritis. Symptoms: stiffness and pain in your lower back in the early morning, which eases through the day or with activity. Pain in the joints where the base of your spine meets your pelvis. Tenderness at the base of your pelvis. This makes sitting uncomfortable. Some may have pain, stiffness, and swelling in their knees or ankles. Enthesitis or inflammation that occurs at any point where tendons or ligaments attach to bone, for example, at the elbow and heel. Tenderness at the heel. Pain and swelling in a finger or toe, known as dactylitis. Chest pain, tiredness or fatigue. Inflammation of the eye, such as uveitis or iritis. Please note that ankylosing spondylitis is not contagious. A gene called HLA-B27 is present in people with ankylosing spondylitis and can be detected by a blood test. However, this gene doesn't mean you'll definitely get ankylosing spondylitis. Only 1 in 18 people with the gene will actually develop the condition. Diagnosis. No single test can be the gold standard to confirm that you have ankylosing spondylitis. So the doctor may need pieces of the puzzle to diagnose, such as the history of your condition, a physical examination, blood tests, for example, the erythrocyte sedimentation rate, or ESR, which may show inflammation, C-reactive protein, or CRP, blood test for HLA-B27 gene. X-rays can confirm the diagnosis, but only if the disease has reached the latter stages. MRI scans may show the typical changes at an earlier stage of the disease. Treatments. Exercise and pay close attention to your posture. Drug treatments, for example, 1. Painkillers and NSAIDs in the form of tablet or gel are usually the first choice of treatment. 2. Disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs like sulfasalazine. They work slowly, so you may feel no change in your condition, but they make a big difference to your symptoms over a period of time. 3. Biological therapies like anti-TNF drugs are newer treatments that can be very effective, like etanercept. Your rheumatologist would guide you if you need them. 4. Steroids, used as a short-term treatment for flare-ups. They're usually given as an injection into a swollen joint. Physiotherapy, to exercise your back and neck to avoid them stiffening into a bent position. Surgery is not required for most patients, but can be recommended for some. Things you can do. Massage and acupuncture. If your heels or feet are affected, place orthotics inside your shoes. Try a hot bath before going to bed. Use a medium firm bed. Putting hot or cold pads. Try to keep the number of pillows to a minimum. Stop smoking. Pay special attention to your posture. However, contrary to usual sickness, bed rest is bad, as this will speed up the stiffening of your spine. If you have ankylosing spondylitis, there's a small chance, around 15%, that your children will also develop it. If you think your child or another relative develops the symptoms, ask them to consult the doctor, as the disease may run in your family.